Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 13 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. For this episode, I'm going to show you how to use Essential Graphics in After Effects. So forget about exporting out to Premiere for now. The purpose of this episode is to show you how you can use Essential Graphics as a part of your After Effects workflow. Now, this isn't a very common use of Essential Graphics, but it really should be, because it is a huge, huge time saver. I've already laid out a basic design, and you can find the project file for that in the description below, or you can create your own and follow along. You can take advantage of Essential Graphics by using it for a purpose that it wasn't necessarily designed for, which for me is super exciting, because I like to find creative ways to use plugins, and this is definitely one of those times. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. So this is a very, very basic design I just kind of threw together. I've got my name, I've got my 13-minute tutorials, I've got a hashtag down here. Then I've got this cityscape over here on the left. One of the things I want to show you is that I've got a variety of backgrounds here. I just put in three for purposes of this illustration. I'm going to do something to this line right here, this line that goes underneath my name. I touched on this last time, but I want to go over it one more time just in case you didn't happen to see that tutorial. This is going to be our, we'll call this name line here. Click P to open that up and Alt click and just type in this expression. I showed you how to save this as a preset in the last episode. So if you've done that, you can just go ahead and apply it from your effects panel. Otherwise, follow along with me and type this in. Notice here how I included the minus instead of the plus. And again, what this script does is it's going to move this bar based on how many characters our name text is. So let's go ahead and move this bar over to where we want it. I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. So just to show you again, if this layer here, this name layer, that's the source for this script. So see, we see D name. That means this layer right here. So let's just change that to Sheila McKnight. And as you can see, it moves the bar. So that way it's always in the same position that we had it, but it moves based on the number of characters that we have in this text layer. So I'm just going to change this back to Jeff Knight. Okay, and so I'm going to show you how we can keep this design, the core of this design, but yet deliver this to a client, say, in different color schemes and using different backgrounds. So I went over this a little bit in the last episode, but let's go ahead and start over as if you've seen nothing. So let's go to layer. We're going to add an adjustment layer, and we're going to call this background. Highlight that, go to Effect, Expression Controls, Checkbox Control. I'm going to open this up a little bit, and let's just rename this Image 1. And then if we duplicate that, it will automatically call it Image 2 and then Image 3. So these expressions control which background right here we use, which building we use. So highlight all of these, hit T to bring up our opacity, and go back up to our background layer. Make sure you lock this down so that way we can click away and it stays up there. Pick whip our opacity from our first buildings layer to the first checkbox, second one to the second image checkbox, and then our third opacity layer to our third image checkbox. And if you remember from last time, at the end of all these expressions, you need to add times 100. So I'm going to type that once, highlight it, and copy it, and then go to this next layer, EE. At the end, just paste that times 100. And the same thing for this bottom layer, EE to bring up our expression. Go to the very end, paste that times 100. Now, if you notice, there are no images in the background. That's because none of these images are checked. So if we check one, we get the first one. Second one, we get the second one. And third, we get the third one. So notice you can check on multiple checkboxes. Whichever one is the highest in the hierarchy is going to show up. So you may just want to make sure you check only one of these boxes. Okay, so now we want to be able to change this with a click of a button and have all of our assets in the same place. So if we go to our main comp here, 57 edit, right click, and we're going to choose open in Essential Graphics. So now you will see that our thumbnail is now updated with what's in our comp. We're going to change this to, we'll just call it design. Okay, so now if we open up our background layer here and see our effect with all of these image checkboxes, the thing you want to grab is the checkbox itself. So drag this up here and we're going to call this image one, grab the checkbox, bring it up and rename it image two. Rename these immediately because otherwise they'll all just say checkbox and you may forget which one it is. And click on this and we'll call this image three. So you can click on each one of these to get whatever image you want. And the reason why you want to do it this way using Essential Graphics is because this way you can have all of your changes in the same place. So I add formatting, let's add a group, and we're going to call this images. So now you can grab these and just drag them into this group here. I mean, want to reorder them so that way it goes 1, 2, 3. Now we can close that up. What if we need to change the background color? Okay, so this is just a solid, this right here. So we need to make sure we add a fill. So now if we open up this layer here and go into effects and go under fill, we're going to grab the color layer. Make sure you're grabbing color layer, pull it up here. And we're going to call this background. I've got these color palettes over here, and this is under my Udemy course. I've got a wider variety of colors than I have under 713. So we're going to use these Udemy colors. And see, as you color drop these colors, it updates immediately, which is super, super helpful. Okay, and then we're going to set the rest of our essential graphics. So for 13-minute AE tutorials, let's open that up and grab our source text and drop that right up here. And we'll call this title. And then go to our name, open up our text, source text. Make sure you're grabbing the source text layer and make that name. And then we have our hashtag here. So under text, source text, drag that up. And we're going to call that hashtag. And again, you may just want to reorder some of these so that way they're in the same order that you see them inside of your timeline. So let's go ahead and I'm going to just lay this out in a way that makes more sense down here. For our name layer, again, we're going to have to add a fill because there's no way to control the color inside of Essential Graphics without a fill. Again, this name layer is pulling its color from our character panel. We need to give it something that it can latch onto. Go to effect, fill, and we're going to make that white for now. And then open this up and go under effects, under fill, grab where it says color. I'm going to put it right underneath my name and just call this name color. So our line is a shape layer and that comes built in with a color. So we have this fill color here, can drag that up and we'll just call this name line color. And then we have our title here. So we need to add a fill. So effect, just add that fill right there. Open up our effects, grab our color and drop it underneath our title. And we'll call this title color. And I want to go ahead and change that to maybe just a white. Okay. And then what else we need to change our hashtag. So this hashtag is, I'm just going to copy this yellow color because we have to add a fill. I'm going to change it to that yellow color. So open up our effects right here and grab this color under fill. And we want to go under hashtag. We'll call that hashtag color. And then we also have this border right here. They call it divider. And again, this is a shape layer. So it comes with a stroke color. And so we can grab that stroke color, bring it up here, and we'll call this divider color. The reason why I wanted to bring all this in here and show you this is because I'm actually working through something very similar to this at my own job. They want the design to be identical, but our client for my job needs this in several different color schemes in order to make a decision exactly what they want. Instead of making a copy of this comp here and then pre-comping things and making other changes, since I brought everything into Essential Graphics, I can change things instantaneously. Okay, so say we want this to be our first design. I can render this out, I can make an image of it, and then say, well, the next one they want to look slightly different. So I click on our background color and maybe I make it look something like this, and then we'll make our name color darker along with the title color, make that a little bit darker. Maybe we want our hashtag to be white instead, and then we want to use the second image instead of the first image. Let's change the line. We'll make that yellow. And maybe we'll make the divider yellow also. Okay, so now we can render this out and we haven't touched the design. We haven't had to make any other pre-comps. The only thing we've done is just make some adjustments inside of Essential Graphics. Maybe for the third design, okay, they want this background of this city. Okay, and maybe they want the background of this for whatever reason to be orange. And they want the name color now to be a lighter blue. And they want the name line color to be a different color. So you can make all of these changes instantaneously. And even though the purpose of Essential Graphics is so you can create things inside of After Effects and then open them up into Premiere and then make changes over there. And that works fantastic. And it saves on project size. It saves on making multiple sequences and multiple nests. You can also use Essential Graphics inside of After Effects solely. And I have done this on a number of occasions and it is super, super helpful. So see, I've only have one comp here and basically one design. I can just render this out. I can make whatever adjustments I need to make. I can change my images instantaneously. And it's all happening inside of one comp. So if you've never used Essential Graphics as an editing tool inside of After Effects, I highly recommend that you kind of change the way you think about Essential Graphics. Yes, it is a fantastic tool that you can use in Premiere, and you can design some really cool things in After Effects and make those changes in Premiere and you're soaking your client. But you can also use this inside of After Effects if you need to make certain changes to a design, but you need the layout to stay exactly the same. Okay, so that's pretty much what I wanted to show you in this episode. I really hope this has been super helpful. And if you have not checked out the other episodes that preceded this one, I highly recommend that you do so. There's a lot of useful information in there, tricks that I've picked up over the years, and I hope it will be as useful to you as it has been for me over the years. And we will see you next time. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I'd love to get your feedback about this episode and also hear about any topic you would like to see covered. And don't forget to sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers. The link to that course, as well as to the project files for this episode, can be found in the description below. And don't forget to check out my two previous episodes so you can learn how to create custom color palettes using CC libraries and then how to use those palettes in Essential Graphics. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time. I'm going to go to bed.